I have decided not to take a break, so that was it, in case you were wondering, because I've come all the way here and I have a lot to help you with and share with you, so I'm good for, I'm just going to go till they yank me out of here. So anyway, in America, the average American has between 2 and 4 bowel movements a week. Now, any of you that read one of my last newsletters on the bowel, you'll see that America, we have awarded ourselves with the number one place of bowel disease in the world. Yeah! We did it! We did it! We have the worst bowels in the world now. Highest rate of colon rectal cancer in the world! Yeah! We've done it for a few reasons. Mostly, what we put in our mouth is like glue. I mean, hey, you guys, you know, if you want to stick 2 2x4s together, the best way to do it is get out some Elmer's glue, put 2 boards together, you can't rip them apart for 100 years. And whose name is on the front of that Elmer's glue but Borden's? And you see Elsie the cow. Elmer's glue is just milk protein. It's a byproduct of the milk industry. Eggs, you know, you go to Venice, Italy, 900-year-old city built on water, still standing. All the walls were made with dirt and eggs. There's the power of cholesterol. And imagine those 12 cows and 6 pigs. What's going on in your bowel? The bottom line is Americans, yes, are 70,000 bowel movements short in their life. That's a lot of waste. You know, I had heard stories from Dr. Christopher and Dr. Jensen and some of my great teachers about people that only had 1 bowel movement a month. I thought, well, come on, guys, they're telling me some natural healing fish stories. And then I remember when a model came to see me. See, my clinic was in Hollywood and Malibu. So almost all my patients were actors, actresses, models, people in the entertainment industry, music industry. And I remember a model came to see me, and she only had 1 bowel movement with her menstrual cycle every 28 days. I was shocked. But then I remember when another woman came to see me who only had a bowel movement every other month, had 6 bowel movements in a year. She was an attorney. I don't know if that had anything to do with it. Then I remember when Teresa came to see me from Santa Rosa, California, and Teresa, during her entire pregnancy, only had 3 bowel movements, 1 per trimester, only had 5 that year. She was a record breaker. My biggest record breaker was a woman that only had 1 bowel movement 1 year. I had a man in Hawaii use one of my products to clean his bowels out, and overnight lost over 50 pounds sitting on the toilet. And I won't tell you what his wife said to me. I have seen parasites and worms, bowls full. I've seen things that look like snakes, cobras. Anisha came from England as one of my graduates to work in my clinic and was shocked at the bottles and jars full of worms that are inside of many of us. In 1 cubic inch, square inch, cubic inch of USDA grade A beef, there's over 1,000 parasite larvae. Now, I know you don't eat that, but you can tell that to other people. And those parasite larvae don't always hurt you as long as you're having 2 or 3 bowel movements a day. But if you are not, they hatch, they hook on, and they live inside you. And let me tell you, when you die, the worms do not crawl in, they crawl out. Most Americans are riddled with parasites. So the first job I had in the clinic was to get people's bowels working, to get them to have a bowel movement regardless of what they ate, regardless of what they thought, regardless of what they drank, regardless of anything. I had to assure myself that they were going to move their bowels the next morning. I had babies that people brought to me with Hirschsprung's disease, a genetic disease where you're born without nerves to your bowel. But God has supplied us with some spectacular plants. Let me tell you, there are 3 million species of plants that grow on this planet, and we only know how to use about 2,000 of them. So we have some work to do. But a few of these plants, actually have a chemical in them referred to as an anthraquinone. And a specific chemical that's an anthraquinone is called amodin. And you find that chemical inside herbs like aloes from the Africa and the Caribbean and the equatorial areas. You find that in centipods that grow in California and the Alexandrian Delta in Egypt. You find them in Cascara sagrada, which grows in the Sierra Nevada mountains. Many plants have this anthraquinone called amodin. And when that goes in your bowel, it makes your bowel move, regardless of whether or not you have nerves to it. It's a direct chemical reaction between those herbs and your bowel tissue. Doesn't have to be assimilated through your blood. It just makes your muscles contract. It's like going to the gym and doing an isolated bicep curl and gets that bowel to move. I had babies with Hirschsprung's disease that were so bad, the doctors wanted to do full colostomies on them or cut out their entire colon when they were only 8 and 9 months old. I had one baby that was so constipated, when they x-rayed it, they found fecal matter backed up to its stomach. And I had another baby that was so constipated, it actually vomited fecal matter. These are the kind of kids we're creating these days. And most of us were constipated. Hey, I remember as a kid, I only went once a week. My dad went once a week. I never had to wipe. It was like a black, hard granite ball. I was afraid it was going to chip the porcelain toilet. I had to sit there about 2 hours and squeeze as hard as I could to get it to come out. I didn't know any different. My son has a bowel movement 3-4 times a day. Half the time he's got to run to the bathroom in the middle of the meal. Now that's the way a bowel is supposed to work. When we eat and we chew food, there's peristalsis or muscular waves in our body that go from our mouth to here. It's one tube from our mouth to our anus. It's a straight tube, okay? And it's just a tube and there's no other way out. And so when you eat food and you chew it and you mix it with saliva, you get a muscular wave down your esophagus. And that muscular wave can trigger another wave in your stomach to start churning and digesting the food, which triggers another muscular wave or contraction through your duodenum to your small intestine, which starts to absorb the food you ate before, which triggers another wave in your colon to remove the food that you ate from the previous meal. That's why you should have a bowel movement 20 to 30 minutes after every major meal. And when I went around the world studying people's bowel habits, and how many of you can say you've done that, I noticed that that was what the way that people's bowels worked, that were healthy, eating simple foods, that had plenty of exercise, just healthy, primitive people had a bowel movement 20 to 30 minutes after every major meal. In America, that doesn't happen. We eat foods that are constipating, foods that are gluey. We have one of the highest animal-based diets in the world. And let me tell you, how much fiber is in all animal food, from milk to dairy to eggs to beef to pork to pigs to all of it? Zero, no fiber. And that, when you don't eat fiber, it can't get back out. Fiber moves it through. So for my patients, I decided to create a formula that would make their bowels work no matter what was going on. That changed my patients' health and lives more than anything else I did. I had heard it from the old natural healers, but I all thought they had some type of bowel fetish because that's all they talked about. But then I saw the changes take place in my clinic, from cataracts to cancer and everything in between, by getting that bowel cleaned out. It's a basic and being healthy. I had people that doctors said were incurable of everything. They cleaned out their bowels, their problems went away. Some of my patients just cleaned their bowels and their diseases went away. So I can't overemphasize the importance of having frequent, healthy, soft bowel movements after every major meal. That's 2 to 3 a day for most of you. And doing periodic bowel cleanses, unless any of you in here are perfect and you never eat anything bad, you need to get your bowels clean. And I saw miracles happen daily in my clinic. I had a man come to me with chronic depression. so bad his hands were frozen in his face and he couldn't pull them off. Been that way for 2 years, had been to all the biggest hospitals in Southern California. They had him to Kaiser, they had him to everywhere. He had seen the best psychiatrist, psychotherapist, was on all the drugs. Nobody could help him. Chronic, debilitating depression. He wouldn't even come in my examination room, and his children couldn't budge him. So I said, let's start at the beginning. The beginning is getting the bowels cleaned out. They bought my herbal formula, my intestinal formula number one, and left. His next appointment was in about 2 weeks, and Anisha told me they canceled. But they did order a half a dozen more bottles of my intestinal formula. Another few weeks go by, canceled the next visit, but bought another half a dozen bottles. And after 2-3 months, I never saw this guy again, but when we checked the records, they had bought almost a case of my bowel formula. And then one day I got a call from his medical doctor, his psychiatrist, and he said, what the heck are you doing to this guy? And I said, what are you talking about? And they said, he comes in the building, he can't even get up to my office, he has to have a bowel movement downstairs. Then he gets up to my office, but before they can bring him in, he has to use the bathroom again. And when he uses it, it smells so bad that all the people that work for me want to leave. He goes, in fact, it smells so bad that he goes, the odor traveled down the elevator shaft and people on the other floors are complaining. But he kept it up, and all the kids did is give him bowel cleansers. And in 4 months, the man had no depression. In 5 months, he was back teaching school. He was a high school teacher. What did I do for his depression? Nothing that I'm aware of directly. I didn't give him ginkgo biloba or some of the other wonderful herbs like cayenne that drive blood and oxygen to the brain that would be a specific for depression. All we did is clean his bowel. But let me tell you, for every disease name you can think of, I had a patient that just did bowel cleansing, and that alone was enough to heal them of their disease. Remember, I talked about two very big basics in getting well. What's going in? Getting it in, the nutrition in, the juicer in, the superfood in, the nutrients in the blood in, to bathe every cell in the best nutrition possible from God's divine gifts. And then in turn, every day after every meal, getting the waste out. Real basic here. This is not an advanced workshop. Get the highest nutrition in and get the waste out. You probably won't need any more information. Stop what you're doing that's making you sick and begin to do what will make you healthy. Get the nutrition in and get the waste out. I saw more miracles happen with that in my clinic than anything else. Hey, when it started out, I got a big ego. I wanted to find some rare herbs, exotic herbs in the rainforest, or maybe so high up on Mount Everest you could hardly get there. And then I thought I would mix them into some very difficult to make formula that would be good for curing the worst kinds of cancer. But my patients had the gall to get well before I could do that, by just doing the basics. See, my great teachers taught me the basics, and they said, you can fiddle around with the fun stuff, but don't ever fool yourself, and make sure your patients know they need to get the nutrition in. They have to have the juicer going, and they have to be eating good food. They have to get the waste out of their body. They have to move their body. They have to love themselves, and they have to create a natural healing lifestyle. Oh, don't clap yet. Thank you. They have to create the natural healing lifestyle. And then you can go ahead and treat the specifics. They all knew I'd never have to do that. 80% of my patients healed themselves with a thorough bowel cleansing. and 95% healed themselves with just the added nutrition. I never got to use the advanced stuff. And if I did, it was probably just hot and cold hydrotherapy. Why did people who came to my clinic get better when they went to other people's clinics and didn't? Why am I so great? Well, I'm awesome looking. I'm a believer. I am passionate about this. I healed myself. But what did I do different? Some people say, well, alternative healing doesn't work. You know what? Most of it don't. Because let me tell you, if you have cancer raging through your body, or your coronary arteries are blocked, or you have a rapidly aggressive neurological disorder and you go to an alternative healer, they're probably going to give you a little body work, spray some essential oils, and make you wear purple clothes. And while they are doing that, the doctors are sharpening the saws and boiling down the chemotherapy and tuning in the radiation beam because they know how to deal with aggressive, intense killer diseases very aggressively. All I did in my clinic is I dealt with them in a natural way, but very aggressively. How much juice can you drink, vegetable juice or fruit juice, before it kills you? I don't know. I tried to kill most of my patients with a juicer, and I never could kill a darn one of them. I tried to kill them with broccoli. Couldn't do it. A lot of people think they're breaking points about here. It's way up over that ceiling. I wasn't able to hurt anybody with carrot juice or broccoli or sprouts or superfood. This is the wonderful blessing too. Live food. Because everything God has given us is in its perfect state for us to consume. Doesn't have to be buffered, altered, or changed. When it comes out of the laboratory, it's dangerous. A little too little, you don't get well. A little too much, you die. That's the story of pharmaceutical drugs. With nature's blessings, put the pedal to the metal. One of the major reasons that people don't get well using alternative healing is they pussyfoot around. Now, let me tell you, I'm assuming everybody in here's partied a little bit. Maybe had some beer, some sodas, and junk food. Let me tell you guys, when you opened up that seventh beer, did you ever call 1-800-Anheuser-Busch and ask them if it was an overdose? Because since it comes in six packs, maybe that's the adult requirement, and maybe seven's one too many? Nah! You just partied hardy, didn't ya? But if I tell you to drink six cups of peppermint tea, you're going to go, I don't know. This could be a little too much. When you open that second bag of Cheetos or pretzels or goldfish or went into that 12-pack of ding-dongs, did you ever wonder if it was an overdose? Nope. Kept going. Kept eating. But you'll go, you know, I've already had two cups of detox tea. I don't want to push things. When you play with mankind's gifts, you swallow and chew and guzzle as much as you can till you're sick. But when you play with nature and God's gifts, you pussyfoot around and back off and are afraid. That is just, we can just appreciate the wonderful job that medicine and the junk food and the liquor and the tobacco industries have done in this country to brainwash us to think that that stuff's okay, but God forbid you go out in your backyard and you eat something that's green that's growing there. That's where you can really hurt yourself. Think about it. Remember I said that medicine has created this medical lie. Go ahead and do anything because we can fix you with a pill. Well, let me tell you, that promoted the meat industry. That promoted the meat industry to where we now have hamburger joints on every corner of every major street in America. That promoted the liquor industry because, hey, If you blow out your liver, you can get a new one. That promoted the cigarette industry, let me tell you. And these industries in turn promoted medicine. You have McDonald's building children's cancer wings in most children's hospitals across America and funding them money back. And you know what causes cancer? Toxins and poisons that they use in the meat industry. We're gonna have to cut that one, for sure. McDonald's goes after everybody that talks at them like that. The tobacco industries have funded millions of dollars to Sloan Kettering, the biggest cancer research hospital in the country. You have medicine promoting you to live a decadent life and will fix you with chemistry. They, in turn, have supported the junk food, the alcohol, tobacco industries, which give money back to medicine. Think about it, guys. You're just a human battery working every day to make money to pay for medicine and junk food and insurance and have nothing left over. We have been ripped off. People say to me, well, what can we do to turn it around? Stop going to doctors. Stop going into a hospital. Stop going into drugstores. And get back in your kitchen with your family where you belong and take a look at what you're putting in your mouth and how it's getting out. I have another formula, a bowel formula I call intestinal formula number two. And that is, once your bowel is working, to go in and get the old stuff out. You have all probably heard of bowel pockets or diverticulosis. This book right here now says that, well, in the 1950s, it said 10% of Americans had herniated intestines due to constipation, where pockets ballooned out of your intestinal wall that you hold old fecal matter in. In the 1970s, they said 20%. In the 1985 edition, they said 40%. And in the latest edition, which is this of the Merck Manual, they say 100% of Americans, if they live long enough, have herniated intestines that have been stretched due to constipation, stuffed with old fecal matter. And let me tell you, it can get pretty nasty when you look into those old intestinal pockets. It's like when you see a scientist taking a core sample of the earth and saying, this is so many years. Well, when you look into these diverticuli, you can almost see that fudgesicle you ate when you were 14. There's some old stuff in there. I had a patient that was, I thought that was funny too. I had a patient that was in a car accident. Her abdominal area was opened up. She went through the windshield of a car. They sewed her back all up. She was fine. I had her do a bowel cleanse. We got windshield glass out when she did it, when she moved her bowels, stuck in those old diverticuli. I had a woman that started checking her fecal matter and it had old coins in it. And her mother told her she swallowed a lot of coins when she was a kid. I always mention that because if any of you are coin collectors, you might want to buy this formula just for some good rare dates. But I found it was necessary to do a two-step bowel cleansing, hence intestinal formula number one and intestinal formula number two. Number one, to get the bowel working immediately, get the waste out. We have no time to waste. The time to start is now. And then once your bowel's working normally, the formula number two, to go in and start dragging off the old debris. I have bentonite clay in it, which removes 40 times its weight in intestinal debris. I have charcoal, which removes 3,000 known chemicals. That's why you have charcoal inside of every water filter you look at. I have fruit pectin in it, which was used in Chernobyl after the nuclear meltdown to remove radiation. Fruit pectin, which is what's inside apples and grapes, grape festival, is proven now to remove heavy metals like mercury and lead and even radioactive material like strontium-90. If any of you have had amalgam fillings and you know you've been poisoned with the mercury in them, fruit pectin's a good way to go. There were all these great old cleanses in the old days, apple cleanses and grape cleanses, because the pectin removes heavy metals and dangerous material. And this formula removes a lot of old waste from inside your bowel that hurts you, that gets reabsorbed back into your body and poisons you. You know, the formula's black because it has charcoal in it. And you know, our ancestors knew to eat charcoal. They knew it was a very healthy thing to do. But nowadays, black is considered not a hip color for food. And I've had a few patients say to me, isn't taking an herbal powder that's made up of ground up plants and is black, isn't that a bit radical? And I've thought about that. And I thought, no, I know what radical is. Radical is my one patient who had such an aggressive brain tumor that when they opened up her skull, they scooped it out like cottage cheese, part of her brain and the tumor, couldn't get it all, so closed her back up. But she was paralyzed and couldn't speak, and as she lied in bed, she said the pain was like someone stabbing her with a hot knife in the skull, but she couldn't scream, and she lied there for 2 weeks. That's radical. Brain surgery is pretty radical. Oh, what's radical? Radical's cardiac bypass surgery, even though it's considered fairly normal nowadays, where they saw your rib cage in half, jack it open, pull your heart out and freeze it, and then cut you from your groin to your ankle, strip nerves out of your leg, and then sew them in as replacement arteries. Maximum, it's going to last for 10 years because a vein isn't like an artery, and you're going to need it again. That's radical. Radical is one of my patients who had a squamous cell rectal tumor. And they said to her, look, we'll just go in and we can do a pinpoint radiation beam on it. Burn that tumor up. You'll be fine. She asked me what I thought. I said, the idea of a radiation beam on my rear end doesn't sound like a great idea. And she goes, no, it's very pinpoint, laser guided. And I was starting to think of General Schwarzkopf when he was pointing to the smart bombs in the Iraqi war, you know, this laser guided stuff. Looked like he had a little problem with his elimination. Maybe we wouldn't have had a war if we all had good elimination. So she decided to have the laser-guided smart bomb radiation, and 2 days later when she went to have a bowel movement, the fecal matter came out her vagina. That's radical. Radical is not consuming plants that grow in our own backyard. Medicine has us so brainwashed. Pick up the latest copy of Reader's Digest, The Investigation of Alternative Healing. They say all sorts of mumbo jumbo is okay, from astrology to acupuncture, and I'm not judging any of those things, but they don't mention plants. Then the next article right after it is how herbs can be dangerous and that you should talk to your doctor first, who's had no training in plants and foods, so he's going to say no. Why would you call the electrician over to your house to ask him why your toilet isn't working? He doesn't understand toilets. Then why do we keep walking back to medical doctors who've had zero training in natural medicine, zero training in herbology, zero training in nutrition outside of pediatric, and ask them if we should use herbs and foods to heal ourselves? Stop torturing yourself and get in the kitchen with your juicer. So, if I were to sum this part of it up, what I saw create the miracles in my clinic was nutrition coming in, getting the juicer going. Some people have said to me, well, if I use fresh juice, do I need superfood? Well, you might not need anything, but why take chances? I want to make sure I'm blasting myself with nutrition, because I know that when I'm loaded with nutrition, I feel good and I can be this excited, passionate, energetic person that you see up here. And if I'm not getting good nutrition, I don't feel so good. So don't sell yourself short. Get as much nutrition as you can in your body, and then make sure you do periodic cleansing of your bowel and get the waste out. You know, on television, I'm traveling now, I'm on the road. I was in San Francisco the last couple days, and I'm going home, and I'm on my way to Europe for 3 weeks tomorrow. And when I'm on the road, I always watch television. I have no television in my house. I refuse to plug myself in to that nightmare. Thank you. But when I'm on the road, I have to catch up with the human race. So I like to watch, you know, what the latest nightmare is, so I'm aware of it, so I can preach and talk about it. And there was a big celebration for a man that was 125 years old, and they were making a big deal about it. Well, they should. Average life expectancy in America is around 70 right now. But let me tell you what I saw when I first looked into the human body. I saw a miracle. We shouldn't be cutting and snipping at the liver. We don't even know how it works. As doctors and scientists, we would like to think we got it all down. And a good doctor will lie to you and tell you they have. But the reality is we know very little. The human body is as infinite as space. It's a miracle. It's amazing. There's only one way to heal it. Stay out of it. Stay out of its way. Stop doing what's doing to break it down. Stop putting mud in the gas tank. Stop collapsing the exhaust system. Set up a great environment for this body to heal itself. Let me tell you, this body was not designed to self-destruct in 70 years. Stanford did some research recently and said that they believe the average age of life expectancy should be 125 years. But let me tell you, the ages in the Old Testament are real. Oh, scientists say, well, they counted different. No, they didn't. Those ages of people living 3 and 4 and 6 and 700 years old, that's how long this thing could last. If we fed it the right nutrition, if we had good elimination. This thing was not designed to blow up in 70 years. Try 700. When I was in India, they discovered a man who was over 240 years old. They had records from his town dating back. Imagine how long this thing can last if we take good care of it. Oh, maybe not in our lifetime. Who knows? But what about our children and their children and their children? When I see Danny come to my crusades and bring in his whole family, I see kids that aren't going to vapor lock at 70, waste away with diseases at 60. I see kids that are going to get more of the potential out of this amazing gift we have been given. But we have to start in the kitchen, and we have to start with eliminating our waste. And we have to start with liking us, maybe even dare to love ourselves. You know, I saw a poll in one of the fashion magazines recently. They polled 1,000 women, and they asked these women if they were happy with the size and shape of their breast and the placement of their nipple. And all 1,000 responded that they weren't happy. And the number one cancer in American women is breast cancer. Is that an accident? We can't look at ourselves with a critical voice, a critical dialogue going on all the time. I walked in that trailer. You know what one of the first things Danny said to me? He said, I love you. And I said, well, I love you. And we both felt better immediately. Think about it. When you wake up in the morning and look into the mirror, what do you see? I get myself in front of the mirror, and I usually sit there and I go, yeah, look at this guy. Sure, I could turn another way and start picking it apart. You know, you could pick on me. What's this beard thing going on? Well, I thought he dropped Woodstock, but what's the ponytail? Well, he looks a little heavy. Maybe he's overeating his tofu. What the heck is this tie? Don't you think that's a little over the top? And what about the vest? I mean, if you want, you can pull it all apart. But one thing I have learned is there's no healing adventure pulling things apart and ripping them down. The healing adventure is with love and loving yourself and loving God. Yeah. Woo! Big smiles, those neuropeptides telling your immune system, you want to live. You want to be 700. That you love food and love eating and juicing and all these things you're going to do. You know, you're Californians, you know a bit, but my clinic was in Hollywood and Malibu. And I used to say that my patients had so much plastic in them that when they died, we should recycle them, not bury them. Don't be hypnotized or mesmerized by the magazines and the movies. There's a great force at work out there to make you unhappy with who you are and your life. And it's a horrible force that I see every day of my life in Hollywood and Malibu and where my clinic is and where I live. It's not real. The movies aren't real. The magazines aren't real. Do you know that when I started my clinic in the 70s, the average age of a print model was 21? And today, the average age of a print model on the cover of a magazine is 15. Okay, what are you looking at? You're looking at a little girl who isn't even into puberty yet. And you're going, why don't I look like that? And then your husband goes, yeah, why don't you look like that? You don't look like that because you're not a kid. You're a woman. My average patient that was 15 had already had 2 cosmetic surgeries. My patients never had the right breast. They either had to pump it into it or take it away. Everything you see in the movies is fake. And the guys, too, they're all getting liposuction. They're getting implants in their calves and in their pecs. They're getting hair pieces. How is it that William Shatner has more hair today than he did on Star Trek 30 years ago? It's called glue. Okay? I'm here to tell you this because my clinic was in that area and I saw that's a fantasy. If you go see a movie or if you watch TV, just remember it's a fantasy. It's not reality. Don't look at that and make your life unhappy or miserable because it's not real. And let me tell you, these people are all miserable and they're all sick. I used to work with a lot of ladies off those beach shows. Breastwatch, Baywatch. Very good. She said, I didn't say it. One of those women came to see me and she was having abdominal pains, and when I was examining her abdomen, I could feel the anterior portion of her lumbar vertebrae right behind her navel. Okay? I mean, that's not well. These people live vomiting their food and on crash diets. They're miserable. They hate themselves. They pump plastic and silicone and saline and collagen into their bodies and their lips and their breasts and the men. And I just want you to know this, because some of us look at that stuff, think it's reality, and just wonder what we did wrong. And I just like to share that a little bit because that's my neighborhood. I had a few people come up to see me during that short tape change and tell me about a relative that maybe had something where a doctor said nothing could be done. One woman came up and mentioned someone that was in a car accident and there was maybe some brain removed and there was something with an eye and they said the eye's dead, it'll never come back. Doctors love playing God and telling you what can't happen. One thing I learned in my clinic was there was a common denominator with all disease, and I called it blockage. When an area of your body gets sick, it's because something can't get there. Now, it might be oxygen. It might be blood, which carries the oxygen. It might be nutrition, just because there isn't enough going in the mouth. But something can't get there. Don't let the doctors tell you what can't happen. Don't believe it. Get the energy, get the nutrition back to that area. Unblock it. You might say, how? Any way you can. Don't run short of ideas. I used a lot of hot and cold in my clinic, hot and cold. If you were to come to my house tonight, you would find that I have all sorts of hydrotherapy set up to heal myself at my house. We have an ice cold shower with a 1-inch line that I took the line all the way from Pacific Coast Highway to get the coldest water I could. Let me tell you, you'll yell Yahoo when you stand under that. My patients that came to see me, you know that woman I told you that had a breast cancer and in 10 days it was gone? 3 surgeons said to remove it. It was malignant and it was rapidly growing. You want to know what the program was? It would take me an hour to tell you. It was everything. But let me give you a little bit. I had her doing a thorough bowel cleanse. I had her stop eating immediately. When you're not well, stop eating. Get the juicer out. I had her juicing all day long. I had her consuming 1 gallon minimum of juices to power the body with nutrition and flush it out. It's not called a juice fast, it's called a juice flush. I had her adding juices that we know are high in beta carotene, like carrots, and also known to be cancer fighters, like the cruciferous vegetables, like broccoli and Brussels sprouts and cabbage and cauliflower. Juice a little of them, a little goes a long way. I had her exercising and I had her swimming because swimming is the great for the lymphatics, especially the breast. I had her doing 40 laps in the pool 3 times a day. Then I had her going in and taking a hot and cold shower with 7 repetitions of hot and cold right on that breast while she massaged it, while she used skin brushing. I had her doing liver flushing along with the liver gallbladder herbs and detox tea. I had her sitting down and praying. I had her doing silent meditations based on her body healing itself. I had her learn 1,000 jokes, and she wasn't very good at it, so I had her call me every day with the humor, because she had to get some level sense of humor. We have to be able to laugh in order to be well. I had her do all sorts of work. She called me up and she goes, I've been into this 23 hours, I haven't gone to bed yet, and I don't have time to finish the daily routine you gave me. Yeah! Okay? You want to get well, or do you want to pussyfoot around? Remember, an aggressive program of natural healing should be as aggressive, because when you go see the doctor, they're going to cut your breast off. They're going to hack your leg off if it's got bone cancer. They're going to pour your body with so much poison, when that needle goes in your arm, you're going to think you were run over by an 18-wheeler. I can't even come close in an aggressive radical program that would equal medicine's approach. So turn the volume up. Turn the volume up all the way. And for those of you that have been told by a godless doctor that you're supposed to be dead or they can't be well, just remember, they're just like the doctor that said, I'd be dead by 20, I'd have no hand, and I'd never walk again. Doctors in this book are limited by mankind's healing. I am not trying to heal the body. I do not know how to heal the body. I do not know how to heal any of you. All I know how to do is teach you how to create a lifestyle using God's divine gifts, and your body will heal itself. Healing a body is way too complex for the human mind. This is a weekend of miracles. Want to know an incredible miracle? You. And with God's help, we have the power to make more of us. Some godless scientist or doctor told some of you that you don't have the ability to heal yourself. And you believed it. Somewhere along the line, you lost your faith. Somewhere you stopped believing. You believed in stainless steel and Pyrex beakers more than you believed in this miracle right here. But when I open something like this up and smell it, I don't see anything like that in the hospital and taste it. But somewhere along the line, we stopped seeing this as the miracle, and we started to think the mammogram was a miracle. At some point, which is worse, you stopped listening to your guts. You stopped listening to your heart. You stopped listening to the voice of God within you. You thought in order to heal the human body, you needed a surgeon or a doctor or a scientist. Maybe you could do it yourself, but you never went to college, or if you did, you never took anatomy, physiology, biochemistry, organic chemistry. How would you know how to heal yourself? You don't. Not by going inside. But how many in here can grow a sunflower? One hand? I thought I was in a farming area. I've seen some beautiful sunflowers on the way here. How do you grow a sunflower? Well, what I know how is I go like this. I drop a seed in and I pour some water on. And I showed that to my son. And last year we grew, 10-foot high sunflowers. And he always likes eating his sunflower seeds, but when he saw what came out of one little seed and how simple it was, he realized the miracle there. Getting well is just like growing a sunflower. Now, to grow that sunflower, did you have to understand photosynthesis? Did you have to know the complex relationship between oxygen and carbon dioxide in plants? Did you have to know how the sun's ultraviolet rays create chlorophyll? Or did you have to know how the oil cells on the leaves can actually transform sunlight? No. You didn't know any of that, did you? You dug a hole, you put in a seed, and you watered it. And you got a 10-foot sunflower. That's what healing this is about. You don't need the anatomy, chemistry, biology, physiology. You don't need it. All you have to do is plant the seed. All you have to do is create the environment around you using the gifts that we have been given, that are provided for us, that are literally growing in your own backyard. And you will be well. It is that simple. My clinic was shut down. I was arrested and it was boarded up in 1994. Do you know why? I figured it out. Because I helped too many people get well. My patients were a living testimony embarrassing modern medicine. My patients that healed themselves of diabetes and cancer and AIDS and arthritis and Alzheimer's and all the diseases that medicine says can't be cured. My patients were living testimony embarrassments to medicine. They arrested me because they thought I healed them. What a joke! Me? Little old me heal somebody? I don't think so. My patients healed themselves with the same power and ability that all of you have. I was fortunate enough to be able to spend the last moments of many of my patients' lives with them. What a blessing. Some of them, I was there when they took their last breath. and my patients, we talked for that final hour or two. And I learned a lot. And they all asked me to share it with you. So I wrote a poem in my book. It's called A Poem from Dr. Schulze's Dead Patients. And I wrote this because I didn't want you to make the same mistakes I saw my mom and dad make and many of my patients make. So let's listen to what they said and see if we can learn anything from it. We screwed up. Don't make our same mistakes. Don't hold back and don't be stingy. We all waited until it was too late and now sitting in our deathbeds, gasping for our last breath. We all agree we wasted our lives. We didn't really live. We would do anything for a few more hours. But all we can do now is warn you and tell you that you're making the same mistakes we did. We regret letting our fear and complacency rule our lives. We didn't go far enough. We didn't live enough. We didn't love enough. I walked in this trailer, and Danny Vieira walked up to me and said, "I love you, Dr. Schulze." He's not wasting his life. He wasn't farting around or being embarrassed or wondering, "Gosh, it's Gay Pride Week. Could I dare say that to Dr. Schulze while in San Francisco they're marching down the streets?" You know, all the fears that could come up. Or do we dare to love and live our life? I hardly got out of San Francisco. We didn't love enough. We didn't take enough chances. We kept our mouths shut and didn't say what we really wanted to say. Any of you in here guilty of that? Yeah. We should have trusted more and believed more and laughed more and loved more. We should have taken more risks and lived life to its fullest. We should have traveled more, worked less, and had more sex. And every one of them said those three things to me. Danny's on his fifth child. He's obviously following that one. It's too late for us now. We have so many unfulfilled wishes and so many unlived dreams. Don't make our same mistakes. Take the chance, take the leap, love life, and live life to the fullest. That's the message from my patients. You want to see a miracle? I saw one crawling around the floor over there. Right there. Hold him up. Hold him up. There's a miracle. Woo! Yeah! That's much more of a miracle than healing yourself and repairing a few busted parts. You guys made each other. You have the power to make each other. Think about that. But you can't blow a few stones out of a gallbladder, repair an eye that doesn't work, fix a spine that's a little crooked, it's a little tumor growing in your body. You can't make that go away. If you wonder what the difference is maybe with you and me, it's I believe. I believed it when I worked for my doctors and I saw the power of the healing that you could have. I then believed it when I told my patients to do it. And now when I saw them heal themselves of everything, I saw how powerful the human body can rapidly heal itself if we just get out of the way. Stop doing what we're doing to hurt ourselves and begin new healing programs. Our body's natural state is wanting to blast you into healing. It's trying. It just runs into a hot dog and a Coca-Cola and some pretzels, and then it can't do it. All you have to do is get rid of the things that are blocking you from healing and add in the things that will give you nutrition and heal you, and your body explodes into healing. You won't be wondering anymore, how can I heal myself? You'll be amazed at how fast your body repairs itself, how you can take a deformed organ and make it undeformed, how you can grow skin where there is none and make a knee come back together. My patients used to say, well, should I go have an ultrasound or some tests or a CAT scan to see if the tumor's gone? And I said, believe me, it's gone. How do you know if you're well? You feel good. You feel better. Getting well is just one foot after the other on this path of healing. Always look for another thing you can do to be healthier. Remember I said, don't be skimpy with yourself. Get all the toys. I look at Danny's website or his pamphlets, and I look at all the wonderful toys he had. Those are toys, and they can be fun. Spend your money on yourself. Remember, that's what your kids want. That's what your family needs. Not the stuff that's in the garage. Don't leave them that. Leave them you. One last thing I'd like to say. Well, actually, a couple. First, it takes a real special person to make something like this happen, and that is Danny and his wife. And I thank them for having the guts to invite someone like me to this event. You can imagine. I have never been politically correct. I have been arrested numerous times. The last time was only a few years ago. They've raided my clinic, they've raided my botanical pharmacy, they've taken me away, they've accused me of making herbal ecstasy with herbs, and I told them the only ecstasy my customers have is when they have a great bowel movement. What I'm saying goes against the government. I was told by the Queen's physician that I was talking anarchy and against the Queen of England when I gave a similar speech as what I did today over in Great Britain. What I want you to know is no matter what anybody says, any man or woman, any doctor or scientist, about what you can't do, remember that I'm telling you, you can do it. You can do it. You can heal yourself of any disease known. I helped my patients heal themselves of diseases, and I didn't even know what the disease was, nor took the time to look it up in that book. There is no limit to what you can do by creating a healthy lifestyle, by getting the juicer and the food out, and starting to use the divine gifts that we have been blessed with. Thank you for having me here today. God bless you.
Thank you. Oh, thank you.
I love you, man.
I love you.
'm Charmaine Vieira. I am standing here in front of Bella Vita Lifestyle Center. Through these doors, many suffering spiritually, mentally, and physically find relief and are filled with gratitude as God works on their heart. Great light has been given to God's church on health reform. As the right arm of the third angel's message, God's methods of treating disease will open doors for the entrance of present truth to prepare souls for the soon coming of Jesus Christ. Here at Modern Manna, we have successfully led the way in a cleansing and detoxifying program that not only touches the body, but also reaches to soul and spirit. We have found that Christ's method of ministry brings true healing. In Volume 7 of the Testimonies, page 62, we are told, "We have come to a time when every member of the church should take hold of the medical missionary work. RISEN, an acronym for our Remedial and Integrated School of Evangelism and Naturopathy, will empower you to answer the call to medical missionary work. Our program is based on the natural hygiene blueprint of the early pioneers, incorporating the 8 laws of health, cleansing, and detoxification. Learn how you can live optimally and coach people to healing from the diseases of lifestyle. Graduates of our Natural Hygiene Coach certification come from all around the world. They are motivated, resourceful, dedicated, and are making a difference through opening their own lifestyle education homes, coaching individuals, working within their local churches and communities, and broadening workplace wellness opportunities. Don't miss out on our upcoming 14-day Natural Hygiene Coach certification program. To find out how you can be involved with this amazing movement, visit us at www.modernmanna.org and click on RISEN to register for the Fundamentals of Natural Hygiene. This online instruction is a prerequisite course that prepares you to successfully complete the Natural Hygiene Coach certification. Jesus says in Luke 10, verse 2, "The laborers are few. Now is the time to join us. He is waiting."